Magic Overtime with Dante and Galante is brought to you by Tobacco Free Florida.
Thanks for taking time to join me on this tape and for giving me this opportunity to review my career with you. I'm Paul Kennedy.
Kick it.
From our Magic Studios in Orlando, Florida, this is Magic Overtime with Dante and Galante.
And welcome, everyone, to Magic Overtime with Dante and Galante. I'm Dante. This is Galante. And that is Paul Kennedy of Sun Sports and Fox Sports Florida.
I feel embarrassed already.
And that was his tape. He actually submitted a tape so that we would have him on the show. That was part of his, part of his tape. We appreciate that,
Paul. I feel like a man that has just burned his last time out.
That was one of one resume tapes we got in. So yeah, congratulations.
Right. Yeah, you know, the thing about it, that was just 2 years ago. Have I changed much?
No. Do you still send that out from time to time?
I've got a couple copies in the trunk, with my pistol.
Well, Paul, we appreciate it. Thanks for taking time to come into our set here. We're going to have a lot of fun. We're looking forward to having PK, one of our favorite guests. But we want you to meet Mad Dog. He's our producer back behind the control. Say hi to Mad Dog. How are you?
Hey, guys. Well, you know what? You duped me again. You got me again on this one. I thought we were having Mr. Kennedy on the show, you know, from the WWE.
Mr. Kennedy!
Oh, that guy. Oh, sorry about
that.
Well,
that is Paul.
Yeah, hold on. Let me unbutton this one right here. There we go.
Once upon a time.
That was a little of this happening.
I got some ink rolling right here. I put my chest toupee on, too.
Nice.
Once upon a time. Well, Mad Dog, sorry to confuse you. Yeah, I apologize. Obviously, this is Paul Kennedy from Sun Sports.
Yeah, I understand that now. But, yeah, I did have to scramble when I saw Paul walk into the studio. Obviously, a guy I had never heard of before. So I did some research. I typed his name into Google, and about 17 pages before I found anything on Paul Kennedy from Sun Sports, I did find these few items. First, we got the old mugshot there.
That came up first.
Could that be a young PK?
Yep.
Right.
Here's the second one, the world's happiest guy there.
Right.
And then
right.
My favorite of all, the Barbie doll field guide. And if you look at the bottom, edited by Paul Kennedy.
By Paul Kennedy.
These all came up on Google before we found anything
on
you.
Paul Kennedy.
Before we got the actual Paul Kennedy.
You know, those checks from Barbie helped me pay for that new automobile I have outside. It's the 50th anniversary year of Barbie.
Probably so. That chest toupee, too.
You like that?
No.
But obviously, Paul, we're having a lot of fun, but you are quite accomplished here in this town. You've been with this Orlando Magic Club since day one.
Since day one.
This is the 20th anniversary.
With Pat Williams selling tickets out in what was a construction site of the Orlando Arena, trying to pitch people to come down.
I don't believe
Let
that.
Us have a basketball team, please. That's true. We were doing that in 1988, the year before the ball club.
And we actually have some video of you since this is our 20th anniversary. We have more video other than your resume tape. We have video from the first ever game in October 1989.
That's our Converse pregame show. You see the logo?
I do see that.
Very nice. When did they get away from the red mic? The red mic's there.
Well, that was our Sunshine Network look. There's Jeff Turner walking into my shot, of course.
Wasn't that the clown nose that you used on the other show you were on? You stuck it on top of your microphone?
Look at the short shorts. The Scott Skiles short shorts. Sam Vincent. Parquet court.
Paul, that was a long time ago.
Sure was. We used sundials by quarter.
Do you also send that out as part of your demo reel as well?
Well, that's the new one.
Yeah.
Right there. You can see how much I have
for
you like that one? Remember the three most often heard words spoken in Orlando at that time were timeout magic. So I was...
I gotcha.
We had a little rough.
Now, you've been doing it for 20 years, Paul. Mm-hmm. What's been, and you've interviewed...
In dog years, that's 180.
Of course. Right, so. You've interviewed countless players, countless celebrities. What's been probably your most favorite interview that you've done, besides this show?
Besides right now.
The night Jeff Turner hit me with a pie on my birthday.
Really?
Yeah, it went all cream pie all over me. I don't know who I was talking to. Matty Gukas used to have to do for an Italian wrestler, used to have to wear a Hospitaliano big green button.
I remember that.
You remember that?
I wish we had
loved
it.
Yeah, we always kid him about that, Coach Gukas. There were a lot of fun. You know who I remember? I remember the rock stars that used to come, like Stephen Stills of Crosby, Stills and Nash, and Payne Stewart when... he was alive. Some of the celebs that would come on a nightly basis, that was always a lot of fun.
So your most memorable celebrity is Stills. From Crosby, Stills, and Nash.
Stills, and Nash.
Well, there was, let me see.
Was this the Englewood Forum? Where are we playing?
Oh, very nice.
Jeez. I love that Three Dog Nights live album. Came out of the Englewood Forum.
PK, how about your least memorable? Like, for me, it's easy. It's Kelvin Cato. He was my least favorite of all time.
You didn't like Kelvin Cato?
I wasn't
Cato?
A big, for some reason, I couldn't get much
one
out of
night, him. One night, we wanted to do Shaq. He was the player of the game, and he would never come on the show. So, at the time, we were giving away little miniature Walkman TV sets to our post-game star of the game.
And heck of Shaq, a giveaway. Right.
Shaq is over there, and Alex Martins was in the public relations director, and he's at the end of the bench, and Shaq is at the end of the bench, and he is signaling me across the court that he can get Shaq, but he's going four. He needs four TV sets. Because it was Christmas time. He's taking care of his guest list. True story. We got him four of those TV sets, and he came over. And
you did it.
Yeah.
You sold out.
Yeah, but we got Shaq.
Well, I understand.
You have to do that.
32. I knew him personally. He liked me a lot.
Right.
Well, you've been doing this for a little bit, and there's a couple of different things that you've done throughout the years, kind of a signature move, and one that comes on Thanksgiving. Comes Thanksgiving week, and we've got some footage of that. Take us through this, PK, your little Thanksgiving tradition here. What are we watching here, PK?
There's Mike Miller putting a sharp object in his hand, right?
That's always smart.
My hair's gotten better, as you see. There's a white Mike flag. Hello. Well, typically and stuff, we would carve, the player of the game would carve the Thanksgiving turkey.
Okay.
And Zach Randolph. I'm sure that
even the opposing. Oh, yeah. He ate that. There's no way he didn't eat that turkey.
Wow. Right. You see the hair starting to get thinner. Yeah, Chris Paul. Right there. He loved chitlins. He said, had to have them on Thanksgiving. True. He's gone on to some success and carving it up.
There's David
Apparently,
West.
We lost 2 years in a row to the Hornets. that's what I take from that. That's not very good.
We had Dwight Howard doing it this year, right in the middle of the interview. There's Jameer.
Now, I tried to get Jameer over there to carve it, and he said, I've never carved one of these before. That was like his first time ever carving the turkey.
Right. When I put this knife in Dwight Howard's hand, I'm sitting there thinking, well, a guy from Turkey on Thanksgiving, wouldn't you think he'd know how to carve it?
No idea.
That's an American holiday. Not
he just put
Turkey.
It down. He didn't even attempt it.
He's a quitter.
But where did that come
He's
from?
He's a quitter.
What got
He's
you
quitter.
Into that? What in God's name made you want
to
do
We need
that?
To kill 2 minutes. We need to kill 2 minutes. Yeah. No. Our good friends at Publix have done that for us every year and given us a big turkey, and then it's a great meal, and I don't have to cook. No. So
you take the rest home.
But this year it was Dwight, but I handed him the knife, and I'm thinking the whole time, now wait a second, if he cuts himself, my career is over.
I should think about that the next time I'm bringing you a player over.
Maybe with the plastic. Maybe yeah.
That might have been your last turkey carving right there with
really?
Dwight Howard.
Well, then viewers would have the complete DVD of right. Thanksgivings with the Magics.
That was it
$9.99.
Right there.
Is it Magic
seconds.
Or Magics?
It's with an X.
Depends on who you ask, which player you ask through the years.
Now, another big day for you. Another big day for you, Paul. You love, and I just found this out. I really didn't know this about you, and I've known you for a while, is birthdays. You're really big into birthdays.
Especially my own.
Oh, right. And you're very selfish when it comes to that.
Nobody loves birthdays more than
Paul. December 17th, by the way, and if you want to get a pen, I'll repeat that for you. No,
what is it about birthdays?
Anniversary. If you love your family, it's a celebration. Do you send your mom flowers? I always do on my birthday. Yeah, thanks, Mom. You did all the work.
Wait, you
I
send
showed
your,
up.
Oh, that makes sense.
I just came.
Here I am.
I never thought about that. I thought it was all about a celebration of myself.
It's not all about you, George.
No.
Big birthday, guys.
You got to have the middle seat.
Right.
It's got to be your show.
Dante's told me that over and over. It's not just about me.
It's not your first name. It's his first name. Your last name.
That's true.
He's done well adjusting to that, though, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's
done well.
But it's the long name. It's Dante and Galante.
It rolls better off the tongue.
Well, right. PK, we appreciate it. We look forward to getting into a lot more here coming up after the break. We got a lot more in store for
this
Paul
isn't
Kennedy.
It. It's not over.
No, there's three segments.
I don't know what they told you when they got you in here, but we're going to keep going, PK. We appreciate it. We're also giving away a pair of tickets, so we want those emails coming in. Go to magicovertime.com, submit your email. Giving away a pair of tickets to the Boston Celtics.
Oh, March 25th.
And the Orlando Magic, March 25th. So you're certainly going to want to get
That's
your hands
a pretty
on
big
those.
Game.
Doc Rivers,
Also text 57375. Is that right? 57375.
Keyword overtime.
Keyword overtime. Get your Orlando Magic, Boston Celtics tickets. Mad Dog, what else we got coming up next?
Well, Dante, when we come back, we'll take a look at a very special 20th anniversary celebration and more with Paul Kennedy. And if you're looking for the perfect gift for the Magic fan in your life, then look no further than OrlandoMagicShop.com. We are offering a special 15% discount code off any jersey purchase. Text the word SHOP right now to 57375 to receive a bounce back code to redeem your discount online. This offer expires March 25th. Magic Text is brought to you by T-Mobile.
Magic Overtime with Dante and Galante is brought to you by Tobacco Free Florida.